joined by one of my favorite guests. We've been doing this for a while now, and he's got another big fight coming up here, this time on May 28th at XFC 44. He's going to be the main event. He's going to be taking on Jose Quinonez. It is Andre Soukhamthath back here on the program. Andre, how's it going, man?
How are you, brother? I'm good.
That's good. Always good catching up with you, man. Always so positive. Congrats again on getting another main event slot here. When did you find out? It seemed like you got plenty of notice for this fight.
I knew that I was going to fight, like, they had a card, and I knew that I wanted to be in the next card because I had a little injury, so that's what kept me from being on the first card. And they just said, you know, hey, just stay ready. We're going to have a show, and I stayed ready. That's exactly what I did.
Yeah.
And now they have a date set in stone, and it's great.
And fighting a fellow UFC vet, it's actually interesting because both of you fought O'Malley, so it's kind of interesting you guys are fighting each other now. So you must have been pretty familiar with him when you took the fight.
Yeah, I knew exactly who he was right away. And you know me by now, it's business. I'm a veteran now, and whoever's going to sign on the dotted line against me, I'm going to do the same.
Yeah, no, that's awesome. Let's talk about that debut fight for XFC, getting the split decision win over Guillermo Fiera. I know you would have wanted the finish, but you must have been happy just getting the win and going through that whole experience, especially fighting during the pandemic.
Yes, of course I wanted the finish, but he was really tough too, and he's a veteran himself. Tough fighter, man, tough fighter. And I'm just happy I got the win, you know. The split decision did kind of scare me because I thought I did dominate fairly at least two of the three rounds, you know. And when they said split decision, that really scared me, but I got the win at the end of the day. So, you know, I've been on the wrong end of a lot of split decisions in my career, but I'm just glad I came out with a W because I really needed that.
How was the whole experience with XFC? You fought for a couple different promotions, the UFC, CES. It seems like from everyone I've talked to, they've really taken care of the fighters quite well.
XFC does a great job taking care of their fighters, man. I'm so happy to be with the promotion because in fight week with them, it was, you know, I fought at the biggest promotion, the UFC, and then it was almost the same as that. You know, we had our photo shoot, they left us alone a little bit, we did a little bit of media, we did a nice weigh-in. You know, the weigh-ins are fun to watch. It's so professional. If you ever check them out, they're awesome to watch. Great DJs, great just filming and great production and great staff. So definitely enjoyed fighting for the XFC, and you could tell that they're trying to think big.
Yeah.
with where they're going with the promotion.
Yeah, no, it's excited for this card as well, too. Let's talk about Quinonez, 8-5 record. A little bit deceiving because he's fought a lot of really good competition throughout his career. You know, if you look at his resume, how do you feel like you match up against him here?
Yeah, I don't think that his record defines what kind of fighter he is. He's a really good fighter. I respect him a lot. I always thought that he was a great scrapper in the UFC also. Dangerous opponent. He could fight on the ground. He could fight on the feet. And he has good cardio. And he's tough, you know. So I think the matchup's going to be a good fight. And you know, may the best man win that night. You know, he's bringing the best out of me. You know, I'll say that right now. I've been focused on nothing but this fight. I've been training really, really hard. I know everyone says that but I've been training really hard, man, physically and mentally. I'm giving it my all, everything. And that's because I have a really tough opponent in front of me. You know, doesn't have to be in the UFC, doesn't have to be in Bellator, doesn't have to be in this is a great fight in the XFC, and I think a lot of people are going to tune in, and a lot of people are excited for this fight.
Yeah, it's a UFC caliber fight for sure. I mean, you just look at the resume of who you both fought. It's a really exciting fight. Training camp, who are you mainly working with for this camp as far as bodies in the gym? Who's helping you get ready for this fight?
Man, I've been working, you know, I've been helping out a lot, getting myself into shape, knowing that I was jumping in the camp, so in the camp, I've been working with, at first to start, I was working with Movzar, the Russian 45er. He's a beast because he has a fight coming up. I said I had a fight coming up. I was a little heavy at that time, so I was like, let's do it. I was working with Edson Barboza a lot, getting him ready for Hurricane Shane. And also, it was going to be good for me, too, because when you get a chance to spar somebody like Edson Barboza, you got to take the opportunity if he's asking you to help him. So I did that. And now these last few weeks, focusing on myself, I've been working with Su Mudaerji, the guy that I fought in China. You know, he's been coming down for his camps at ATT, and you know, no egos here, man. He's a young fighter. He's 23 years old, 24 years old, and I'm 32, man. So if he can help me out to win this fight, because this fight's really important to me, I appreciate that. And if I can help him become the next Asian superstar, I'm going to do that for him, you know? So it's all good.
What was that first interaction like when you guys saw each other? Like, did you know he was coming to the gym? Like, tell me that first moment when you guys saw each other.
He first came to the gym when I was in Seattle. And then I guess he came back now that I'm back. And I was just like, I was kind of shocked. And I was just like, but I knew that he's been here before. So I was just like, hey, what's up? You know? Just like nothing, you know, and he was always like, hey, what's up, you know, we won't really speak because he doesn't really speak English, but it's kind of like body language, but
there's a respect there, right? You guys fought each other.
Exactly. Know? Even leading up to the fight, we both had to spend time in the UFC PI in Shanghai. So we literally had breakfast across from each other almost every day, you know, and it was the same thing. Like we look a little smile sometimes, and then once started going closer to the fight, a little more serious, but still respect, you know. But yeah, it's been good training with him because he's all over the place. He's very dynamic and he's a little similar like Quinonez, size wise.
Yeah, I was gonna say probably a good look in that regard. Who's gonna be in your corner for this fight? Who's gonna be in the cage with you?
Master Catel Cubas and Adriano. One championship.
I know. What a win that was, huh? That was incredible.
That was amazing, yes. And I was in his corner for that fight, too.
That's right. Oh, yeah, I remember that. Yeah, that's awesome.
And, he was in the corner in XFC 43 for me against Guilherme. So, you know, he's the same person, man. Same Adriano. He's helping me a lot for this fight, and I appreciate him now that he's big time champion, you know, beat the GOAT. He's still gonna go with me to the fight, so
that's cool. Yeah, I can't have a better corner than that. And also, we should mention TikTok star as well. That video with him and Lineker was pretty funny, right?
Oh yeah, that was fun. I was actually right there watching it and filming it.
I just love how serious they were. Like, they took it like very I thought it turned out great. It was really funny.
It was funny, man. It was a good time because after the fight, we were just hanging out, you know, our last day there, and we're like, hey, let's mess around a little bit, and they decided to do that.
How's this fight playing out on May 28th?
Man, it's gonna be a good challenge, but I think it's gonna be a chess match at first, but I think I'm gonna figure him out, and of course, I always say this, I'm not afraid to hide it. He's gonna feel my power, the way I hit, the way I kick, the way I punch, the way I throw my knees, and he's going to be like, whoa, and that's when I take over.
Do you have any idea sort of what's next? Because you're not part of the tournament, correct? You're just sort of like, because they don't have a bantamweight tournament, right?
I don't think they have a bantamweight tournament right now, but I think if they do have one, I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know what kind of caliber bantamweight fights they're looking for. You know, if they're looking for guys with my experience or up-and-comers or young guns. Never really spoke about it. It did come across for conversation, but I told them, and I'm sure they're on the same page, like, I'm main eventing two times now, right, with XFC, and listen, I'm a super fight guy. And if they want to have a tournament, okay, let's have a tournament, but I already fought two times already, and I think my next fight should be a title or something, and whoever wants to challenge me, you got to work your way up that tournament. Because I, even though I'm a UFC veteran and I have experience, I'm not going in there saying, hey, I need a title shot just because of my name, because of my big name.
You want to earn it. Yeah, exactly.
I'm trying to earn it, you know, and I think I'm proving that. I fought a tough vet. I beat him from Brazil, and now I'm fighting a UFC vet. This could be a title fight, but I said, no, I want to earn it. I want to be 2-0 at least and get on the run before, you know, title talks come into the picture. So I expect that it should be fair for anyone challenging me in the future, you know?
Before we go, how's the family doing? Because you guys have been back in Florida now for a little bit since moving to Seattle. It seems like you guys are all settled. I'm kind of trying to pay attention on Instagram. Seems like everything's going well being back.
Yeah, everything's going good. You know, once we got settled with the house and stuff, in our new office right now, like we mentioned, you know, we just doing a little bit of things around the house and getting the kids back into school and just trying to be a family, man, you know. And at the same time, we're a fairly young couple, still trying to chase our dreams and our goals so that we can, you know, have a better life for our family. That's it, man.
And that continues here on May 28th. It's XFC 44. Andre, always appreciate the time, man. Just remind people where they can get a hold of you on social media. And if you got any sponsors or shout outs, I'll give you the last word.
I appreciate all my sponsors, man. You guys know who you are. Keep an eye out for them on social media. And my social media is Andre Souk MMA on Twitter and Instagram. Check out my YouTube channel, too. Just started vlogging Fight Weeks. And I also do daddy vlogs. So check me out on YouTube.